simple, healthful things. Some patients knew a little plant medicine. These I would listen to, hear what they had tried, and if an answer whistled in my ear, I might whisper the advice I was given. What Auntie called my gift showed itself as a deep intuition. It gave me insights, flashes of knowledge, the smell of death, the hint of what treatment to choose. I was a novice and at times wanted either to shut out the gifts or to find someone who could develop them in me. Kath or Jane would, of course, teach me everything, but my stubbornness kept us estranged. As an adjunct to Western medicine, their knowledge would make an extraordinary tool. The more I learned in the hospital, the clearer this became. Auntie brushed my mind from time to time, so I knew she was thinking of me still. I told myself I was waiting for her to say sorry, but of course she'd tried many, many times, and I had ripped up or burned her letters and refused to answer her calls. I didn't know what made me feel so vindictive, so unforgiving, and I had no idea how to fix it. In this way, 6 years passed. I worked, played a bit of netball, trained at a local gym, and swam endless laps in the tepid baths. My life was full and empty. I had friends, got letters from Jane and Tommy, but there was an aching hole where my family used to be. I missed Kath's homespun wisdom, my dad's crosswords, the endless but in the end flawed love of my mother, and the memory of our shared pain when Anahira died. I'd then remember Mum's failings, her fragility, which gave Rick easy access to me and to Max. My anger at her would flare again. She was a mother. They were not allowed to show weakness. She should have always been as strong as she was before Anahira, when I could trust her to keep me safe, when she didn't think bad things about me.